In 1969, WKBW's legendary program director, Jeff Kay, took a chance on a fresh, young talent out of Buffalo State College, Al Wallach.
Time right now is about 24 minutes before the hour of 12 o'clock, and a weekend edition of Al Wallach. That's the only edition, I guess. I'm sure it ends. 69 degrees outside on date night in Buffalo at
WKBW. The music people.
Al has not been out of the business since. He celebrates 45 years in broadcasting in 2014.
The Sound of America continues with Al Wallach.
No, don't come home a-drinking with loving on your mind.
Listen here, when you come home drinking, what else is there?
More music, WWOL.
Al has worked at WWOL, WNIA, WBUF, and WYSL AM and FM in Buffalo. Plus WBUZ in Fredonia, WUSJ in Lockport, WKBK in Keene, New Hampshire, and WPGC in Washington, D.C. It was at WEBR where Al Wallach made his mark in broadcasting. He joined the station in 1972 as host of the All Night Show. He then moved to middays and became production director.
That's Aretha Franklin. Ain't she good? It's 101 with Al Wallach.
Is that a fact?
Oh, cut it out.
That is a fact.
We are WEBR, Buffalo.
Together we can make it happen.
Hello there.
In 1976, Wallach became host of one of the most popular jazz programs in Buffalo broadcasting history, Jazz in the Nighttime.
I got my mojo working, baby, and I'm gonna try it on you.
At 9 p.m. Monday through Friday, Wallach would delight Western New York jazz aficionados with a wonderful blend of mainstream jazz, from Dave Brubeck to Dizzy Gillespie.
Oh, yeah. Well, I tried in New York.
Wallach once majored in education for emotionally handicapped children. This, he said, prepared me for dealing effectively with disc jockeys.
I got my mojo working, baby, and I'm going to try it on you.
Charlie Mancuso, music professor at Buffalo State College, reflects on Al Wallach's influence as a pioneering jazz DJ.
In the annals of Buffalo jazz DJs, he was, and he wasn't just a jazz guy, as we know, he was by far the most underrated and underappreciated of all of those names who I've mentioned. And maybe it was not so much his fault. It's just he's so self-effacing. You know, he knew how serious the other guys took all this music, which is a serious music that we love. You know, my nickname was Jazz with Jazz. But he brought a sense of humor to it all, and he leveled the playing field that these were gods in a lot of our eyes and our ears. But he humanized them, and he was better at that than any of the DJs who were heroes of mine that I ever heard before. He was the everyman jazz DJ.
In 1993, Wallach was named operations director of the newly rebranded WNED AM 970, also serving as the station's program director for 12 years. Wallach's smooth delivery made him an obvious choice to voice IDs and promos on WNED-TV. He narrated many of the station's locally produced documentaries, and Wallach played a significant role in the production of Don't Touch That Dial, a WNED documentary on the history of Buffalo broadcasting. Today, Al Wallach continues as the voice of Buffalo's 24-hour jazz station, WBFO HD2. Al is also a founding member of the Buffalo Broadcasters Association. It's with great pride that we induct Al Wallach into the Buffalo Broadcasters Association Hall of Fame class of 2013.